Hey, what's going on, you guys? Chad Christian coming at you with another exciting video. Today we're going to install Windows 10 on the brand new MacBook Pro. So the first thing that you need to do here is you can go out and Google Windows 10 download, and we're looking for the Windows 10 ISO. Make sure you do get it from a Microsoft site. Be careful out there. Choose the version you want, and in this case we're going to use Windows 10. Choose which language we want. Go ahead and confirm that. Now I'm going to choose 64-bit version. You can choose 32 or 64, it's up to you. Now once this file gets downloaded, you can go ahead and close out of your web browser. And what we're going to do is I'm going to go up here into the spotlight and I'm going to type in Bootcamp Assistant, and I'm going to go ahead and launch that now. And once we get that launched, go ahead and click continue. We're going to choose the ISO image that we just downloaded. Now it's going to allow us the choice of how large we want our partition size to be, and you can change that just by simply dragging the bar. I'm going to keep it at its lowest setting, which is 40 gigs. Go ahead and click on install. Once you do that, it is now going to download all the Windows support software that it needs, so when it boots into Windows, it's going to be able to have all of the drivers. So once that's done, the system is going to restart into Windows 10 here automatically, so it's just going to start the setup. We're just going to go ahead and click next. I know it's kind of hard to see here, but it's just asking, do you wish to install this? And which version do you want, home or professional? I'm going to go ahead and choose the home installation, and that I don't have a product key. You don't have to put one in just to install the software. Side note though, you cannot get any security updates or Windows Defender or anything if you do not register this license of Windows. So if you're planning on keeping it, I highly suggest you do that. Now it's just going to ask for the account name, so I'm going to go ahead and key that in here. And click next. Yes, I want to use Cortana. She's awesome. Once that gets done, you're going to click on install for the Bootcamp installer, which you do want because that does add drivers, and anytime any Windows updated drivers for this MacBook comes out, it will download those for you, so you do want to make sure you install this. And if anything pops up, and in this case it's just a Broadcom, looks like a network driver, we do want to install it. You can see now that it's adding all the special Apple drivers. This actually works fantastic as a Windows device. So any of you college kids or programmers out there that are looking at which system to get, Windows or Mac, the nice thing with this is you can dual boot into the system and now you have both. So you don't have to worry about which choice to make if you get the MacBooks. Then you have both operating systems. Now if you click here on the bottom, you'll see the Bootcamp is installed. What this will allow you to do is if you want to, you can just tell it to go ahead and boot into your Mac operating system right from this. The other way to do that, of course, is anytime you boot up the machine or restart the machine, if you hold down your Option key, which I'll hold it down now, you then get to choose which operating system you want to boot into. So right here you can choose Macintosh or Windows. And in this case, I'm going to boot into the Mac, and there you go. That's all you need to do to set that up. And that's going to do it for my video today. I hope you guys liked it. If you did, hit that thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe. On the next video, I am going to show you guys how to run Steam on this with an external SSD drive. So make sure you stick around. And I'll see you guys on the next video.